Let us continue with the first module, that is introduction. Now the next we are going to study the Unix architecture and components. So you can see the diagram here. In the center part it is has the hardware, then it is a kernel, and after that the shell. So different shells are there: shell, K shell, B bash. So these are the shells, and along with the different commands are there, utilities are there, like vi, ed, cut, env, pg. So these are the different commands in Unix operating system, and they are also called utilities. After that, the outer part that has the application programs, mail, FTP, and DBMS. So this is how the Unix operating system are written, and this is how it is structured. Now we will go in a detail. So the main concept that unites all the version of Unix is following four basics: kernel. So the kernel, as you can see in the diagram, the kernel is the core part of the Unix operating system. So the kernel is the heart of the operating system, and it interacts with the hardware and most of the tasks like memory management, task scheduling, and file management. So it is the kernel which is responsible to take care of memory management, task scheduling, and file management in the Unix operating system. It interacts with all the hardwares and do all the management in the operating system. The next important part is the shell. The different shells are there: C shell, K shell, bash shell. So different shells are there. So shell is the utility that processes your requests. When you type in a command at your terminal, the shell interprets the command and calls the program that you want. So whatever program we want it to be executed, we provide it to the shell, and shell executes those commands. The shell uses a standard syntax for all commands. C shell, bourne shell, and corn shell are the most famous shells which are available with most of the Unix variants. So it is the shell program which executes the commands in the Unix operating system. Next is commands and utilities. So there are various commands and utilities which we can make use of in our day-to-day activities, like the different commands which we have: a cp, mv, cat, and grep, etc. are few example of commands and utilities. These are over 250 standard. There are over 250 standard commands plus numerous other provided through third party software. All the commands come along with various options. So around 250 standard commands are there with thousands of different options. So like cp, mv, cat, and grep, these are few commands example. We are going to study all these commands in detail in the further slides. The fourth main part of Unix operating systems are the files and directories. All the data of Unix is organized into files. All files are then organized into directories. These directories are further organized into a tree-like structure called file system. So the files and directories are organized in a hierarchy way in Unix operating system. Previously also I said in the feature of Unix operating system that all the files in Unix operating system are arranged in hierarchy way. So like in a directory, different files will be there. In those files, different subfiles will be there, text files will be there, and all those things. So files are arranged very properly in like a tree like structure using parent child system in a Unix operating system. Next is a POSIX and single Unix specification. Since because many version of Unix exist today, and each of them provides into own set of Unix API functions, it is difficult for system developers to create applications that can be easily ported to different version of Unix. So this is what has happened. Unix, firstly, it was written by the Dennis Ritchie and J. Thompson. Later on, the different version of Unix was prepared, called Fedora, Red Hat, and all those things. So since different version of Unix exist today, so developers got confused, and it becomes very difficult to write a program in one version of Unix and which may run in another version of Unix or not. So to overcome this, the IEEE society was formed a special task force called POSIX, Portable Operating System Interface. So POSIX, that is Portable Operating System Interface for Computer Environment, refers to operating system based on Unix. So it is developed at IEEE, refers to operating system based on Unix. POSIX.1, C application programming interface, the system calls. POSIX.2, it deals with the shell and utility. POSIX.4, it deals, apart from those features, it also deals with the thread management. Unification of two standard, POSIX.1 and POSIX.2, known as single Unix specification. Write once, adopt anywhere. Once the software has been developed on any POSIX, it can be easily ported to another POSIX Unix machine with lesser modification. So this is what the combined version of POSIX.1 and POSIX.2 was formed, and that is called as single Unix specification. So it has the features write once, adopt anywhere. Once the software has been developed on any POSIX, it can be easily ported to another POSIX Unix machine with lesser modification. So those applications which follow the single Unix specification, they can be written on any Unix operating system version like Fedora, Red Hat, Solaris, and all these things, and it can be run in any other version of the Unix operating system.